For Your Entertainment is sponsored by Kevin's Lamp and Fixture Repair.
Hey, 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 once again, welcome to For Your Entertainment. My name is DJ MZ Hammer. It's great to be back here at BCTV, and I hope everyone's having a nice, safe, fun summer. I know it's been hot out here, but we're going to cool it down here tonight with tonight's show with a cool, fabulous, talented guest tonight, Wendy Thompson, and she's going to start off playing that harp right there for us right now. Thank you so much for being on our show tonight. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Thanks for inviting me.
You're welcome. Now, before we get into your instruments, I'd just like to dig in to see how you started your musical adventure. I see that you started at a young age as far as playing other instruments.
Yes. When I was a child, I played the piano and various woodwind instruments. I always have liked music. But when I learned about the harp, I was almost 50 years old, and I fell in love with the harp. So I learned about it because my sons were in the orchestra, and there was a beautiful big harp in the back of the orchestra, and I liked the way it felt being near a harp. So I did some research.
How were you inspired to play instruments? Was your family trained also, your mom and dad trained? As far as that, or how'd you, high school or what?
That's a good question. I naturally am more of a quiet person, and I found it to be very expressive to be able to play an instrument. I don't sing, I wish I did, but playing instruments has given me a lot of joy.
Okay. You should hear me sing, Wendy.
Okay.
Maybe someday, gang, all right? But not tonight. Tonight's all about Wendy Thompson here. Tell us a little bit what you brought with you tonight.
Okay, so I have two harps, and the reason I brought two harps is to show how they're the same and different. I'm actually very fortunate that I have four harps in my home. I brought only two that I could carry.
You only brought two, and there's bigger ones?
Yes, so I have another one that's this size, and then I have a great big one that's a different kind of a harp. This little harp that I'm holding and this harp are in the family called a lever harp. And as you can see, the levers on both harps are the reason that it's called a lever harp. But they have a purpose. And what it does is, just like a piano, it creates the black notes on, or the half steps between the notes. So for example, if I play a note, it will give me another pitch. So another interesting thing about the harp is it's the only stringed instruments that have that are colored. And the reason for that is so that I know what notes they are. So all the red strings are C's. So an octave. This is set up very much like a piano. And you can see on this other harp, it is also set up this way. But if I were to, you know, having a live demonstration with someone here, I'll ask you, MZ, what is the same or different besides that they both have levers and they both are colored? What is same or different between these two?
The string tension.
Okay. Yeah. So, good point there. They have actually the same. The tension is should be the same. So all the reds are C's on here too. The tension is the same, but this has more strings.
More strings than
this one. There's advantage to having more strings. You can play more notes. You can play deeper notes.
Oh, okay.
So the longer the string and the thicker the string, the deeper the note. So anything up here is going to be very high.
Yeah, that's very, very high.
Yes. So the reason I have a really big harp at home is because it has even more strings, and we don't have time to put a lever up for a sharp. We do all the sharps with our feet. In addition, we can make all the flats. So a flat is when you lower the note a little bit.
Well, that's what I would be. I'd be flat for sure. Anyhow, what's the pedal harp? I know you said that that's your biggest harp.
Yes.
What does the pedal help you
do
as far as that? You know, what is a pedal harp?
Okay, so a pedal harp is much bigger than this. It's taller than me. It has 7 pedals at the base. And if I would like to make an F sharp on my lever harp, I have to manually take my hand and move the Fs to sharp. For a pedal harp, all I need to do is find the F pedal and push it down. So it's at a neutral position. If I push it all the way down, it's an F sharp. If I let it go all the way up, it's an F flat. So I have all the different sharps and flats that I would possibly need. So you can play everything on a pedal harp.
Okay.
The disadvantage is it's so much more expensive. It's so much more heavy.
Yeah, I bet.
And it's hard to get around. It gets
and that's used for orchestra?
Orchestra, yes.
Have you been in an orchestra, Wendy?
I have not been in an orchestra with a harp.
Okay.
But I love my pedal harp, and I'm taking lessons from an excellent teacher. When I first learned, though, I started on this little lever harp, which we call a therapy harp. So what I played in the...
Let's go into the therapy part, okay? That's a whole different ballgame, correct?
Yes.
That's a wonderful thing to go into. You go into hospitals, right?
Yes.
And you play for the people that are operated and they're recovering and they're down on their luck, whatever.
Well, you know, actually...
Explain what a harp therapist is for their TV out there.
Sure. So there's music therapists, and that is a college degree. Someone would study how to have certain outcomes with patients. And it's a wonderful role and very much needed. Therapeutic musicians, which is what I am, is also very needed and can work alongside.
And you went to school for that or taught?
So I
certified.
Took courses. I have a certification, and it's not a college degree. It's a certification that I started when my youngest son was in high school.
How long did it take you to get that certification?
4 years.
4 years of constant training.
Yeah, well, not constant, but a lot of long weekends and a lot of hours of playing in the hospital. So when I first played in the hospital, when I was getting my hours, we call it, you start playing a lot of simple things. So this is a very simple instrument to play.
Pretend I'm a patient, okay?
Okay, yeah.
What would you do? You come walking into the door, right? You come into the room?
Yes.
What would you do? Show me what
okay,
exactly.
Okay, so that's why I'm standing, is so that you could walk around in a hospital, but I'm not just playing for the patients. I'm playing for perhaps your wife would be with you, or the nurse that is so tired from working all night.
Okay.
Or so the staff, the visitors, the patients, everyone, that's who I'm playing for. So when I come to your door, I don't just walk in. I might play a little bit at your door.
Okay, my back is hurting, Wendy.
And then you're...
I need some therapy. Let's listen to Wendy play some more, okay? Was that a hymn?
Well, I like to
I kind of recognize it from a hymn.
So I like to do a mix. Sometimes I don't play the entire song. So how harp therapy is different than playing a harp in a performance is at the end of a song, there's a pause and people would clap. For harp therapy, don't really encourage anyone to clap. What we're trying to do is, if I'm observing correctly, and there's a lot of training in this, seeing what might resonate with you. You start humming along to a hymn,
mm-hmm.
or maybe
okay.
something is recognizable, or you start talking about when you took piano lessons as a child or something. And I don't really talk. I'm following along with what would
work. So that's how you know what to play, basically?
You
see the vibes coming from the people?
Right, a lot of training in that. And a lot of training.
So that's part of your training, is recognizing mm-hmm. what ails them. And
it has rewarded me so much, MCV.
Not only them, but it rewards you.
Me,
because you
yes.
see they're happy.
Well, yeah, there's that, but also...
Their spirits are being lifted.
I just last week playing for a woman, I thought she had an expression of, I don't want any music, which is always someone's right. They don't have to hear the harp. You know, I can go on to the next room. Would you like to hear any harp? No, thank you. It's
okay.
Fine. Yes, I'm not going to. I'm here for comfort. So, but I thought, I think she's going to say, no thanks.
Yeah.
And she just started singing. I was so surprised, and you know, we know in life to never judge anyone.
Right.
But she was in pain. That's why her face was set in such a way that looked like it was "don't bother me" look. And I also,
you just sense it, that people don't want to be.
Yeah, that it's
either having a bad day, or
they're having a bad day, or maybe the harp mm-hmm. they've only seen in funerals, and they think, it's not my time yet. I hear once in a while someone will say, is this the end? It's not. We're just here for comfort. I meet people, the most amazing people in the infusion center, and
mm-hmm.
A man who is quadriplegic. He's so grateful for every single day. And I leave the hospital so inspired every time I go. It's a lovely instrument to play because you're hugging it. And so one of the things that's so wonderful about a harp is it's having these wonderful vibrations.
Okay.
And since we're made of a lot of water, we're feeling it, but I'm really feeling the vibrations because it's right next to me. It's I'm hugging it, and it's vibrating. So the closer I am to a patient,
yeah, it's part of you.
It really is
and
relaxing.
And that's the way you got to treat it if you're going to perform well, correct?
Right. And you know, I go around, and sometimes I'll stay quite a while with a patient, and then, you know, I say, you know, it was so nice to meet you, and I always learn something new. It's the best job ever. I work currently for St. Joseph's Hospital in Reading, through the pastoral care department, and their mission is also comfort. So I'm
that's wonderful, that. Wendy, that so you're doing that.
It's a lot.
How can people can you get a hold of you if they need you to do something?
I would say
for them?
Through the pastoral care department at St. Joseph's. They have all my information.
They have your information.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, and I've played I have played for funerals. I'm playing for a wedding. I play for.
Ooh, you do private parties.
Yeah, I played at Reading Museum recently.
Oh, okay.
I guess that was in May. So I'm always open to try new things.
Cool.
My first love is as a harp therapist. So I like to.
I never heard of one. I never heard of a harp therapist. I'm sorry.
I didn't know about it.
And that's
it
why
either.
I wanted you to get you on the show because I was fascinated. My wife met you and she gave me your card and. How about if we bring up those pictures?
Okay,
and see
sure,
them? Can we,
sure.
Joan, can we have those pictures? You want to check the monitor there, Wendy? And
oh.
There's you.
Right. Right. Yeah. So, yeah, that's with this other harp. And one of the interesting.
We're going to try to play that tonight.
Yeah.
I promise you.
Okay.
We're going to go through quickly, Wendy, of these pictures, okay?
Okay.
If you bring them up, there's another one of you.
Okay, with the two harps. Yeah, we didn't talk about what this harp is made out of yet.
Yeah, right.
Right?
Yeah.
This one is made out of wood, and this one is not made out of wood.
Okay.
Now, this
and
picture.
That's more travelable, right? You can travel.
Right. This is lightweight. So it's not made out of wood. So we can be thinking about that. So that last picture was in the mix because.
There you go. Egyptians.
Yeah. See,
that's
you can
how
see,
far back it goes, right?
Right. Yeah. The harp, 2,000 years we've had records of harps. Now, you can see it's very different than the harps that I'm showing. There's no levers. You know, it doesn't have this, you know, important support piece of wood right here. However, musicians were playing for. Like a pharaoh after he died and often were buried in the tomb with the
harp.
With the king. Yeah, and playing the harp. That they saw that as an honor.
So King Tut has a harp in his
I don't know specifically King Tut, but
tomb.
There has been depictions of harps going back as far as that. And some people say, well, how did the harp originally come to be? Well, some people think that maybe the shepherds out on a mountaintop that have a bow and arrow to protect their sheep might have had some wind go through their their bow and arrow, and then it came up. And you could see here we have a Cupid. And what's interesting thing with a Cupid is like sometimes you see with a bow and arrow, and sometimes you see a bow the Cupid holding a harp. So it's another interesting interchange between those two things that people have trying to conclude that maybe that the harp could have started.
That picture, you see them all over the place.
Right,
yeah,
little harps. Yeah. So that's one theory, but it has been around a long time. It's sort of one of the iconic symbols of Ireland outside of the shamrock, right?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Yeah, there's harps
I thought the shamrock
everywhere.
And a good frosted mug of beer was
right.
It?
Well, the Guinness has the little harp on it, if you see that.
Okay.
Yeah, my brother-in-law is Irish.
I stand corrected.
Yeah.
Is that all the pictures, Wendy, you got?
Yeah, just bringing back, you know, the harp has been used for ceremonies for so long, particularly, you know.
Can I
weddings.
Get you to jump one over there?
Sure,
on
sure.
The, while, we, while you talk about that picture, Wendy, can you... Can you do both?
Yeah, I can.
I know you can, because you're very talented. Wendy Thompson right here on For Your Entertainment.
She's
getting back over there. She's jumping over to her other harp, and we're going to play a little bit.
Yep. And then we didn't.
So this goes back thousands of years. The harp.
Thousands of years. And it's been in the Bible, references in the Bible lots of times. So They have...
Right, there you go. What's that, Wendy, now? What's?
Yeah, so that's just a very unusual picture of one of
the earlier harps. Right? A pharaoh?
Yeah, I think in the Egyptian times for sure.
Yeah.
But yeah, harps were played. Now that kind of thing would get out of tune all the time, as you can see, and there's no way to...
Yeah.
You'd have to individually make the tension for each
string.
But
that's just some of the ideas that you brought that shows that it goes back that far.
Right, right, yeah.
What can you play on now, this bigger harp? What can you play now?
Well, I can play all the same things that I would play on my little therapy harp, but I just have more strings. So if I played like Hallelujah,
okay.
I could also play it, at a lower register.
Okay. Check it out, Wendy Thompson.
So really deep, but I'll start it up here.
Sure.
So you would play this, and then you could also play anything down here. Okay. Sometimes it's not even a song, but interesting patterns,
yes.
And it's fun to play around with that, too.
Yes, that's symbolic of the harp.
Right,
is that strumming.
Right. And people do play bigger harps for patients in the hospital, something as big as this. And they would probably play something where they could look at the patient and something very simple. And maybe just make up something in there so you can watch the person you're playing for. And that's what the therapy, people get a relaxation response. And for some people, it might be actually physically their shoulders drop. And you can say, okay, it's working. And I've had sometimes a patient or their family have tears. And I was, are you okay? Is this, you know, because I don't ever want anyone to be
because
hurt.
That brings out the emotion of seeing their loved one
exactly
laying there,
right?
And your music brings kind of a joy.
It does, and the patient smiled for the first time in weeks,
right.
And it made the wife cry.
Right.
But it was, she said, it was happy tears. So that makes me happy. But I always check to make sure because we never want to do any harm. So.
All right, then can you play something?
Okay, sure.
On that beautiful harp of yours there.
Okay. So I'll play a song called Sky Boat Song. So I need F sharp, so I'm going to take all the blue notes and make them sharp.
And time flies, Wendy. We got 4 minutes.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. So this is the theme song from Outlander. I think it's the TV series.
Okay, I've heard of it.
She goes back in time to the date of this song is 1746. So I looked it up. That's when she goes back in the first of the series. She
cool.
goes back. Thank you.
And that was called?
Sky Boat Song. It's a very old song from 1746, but it's also the theme song of Outlander.
Okay.
I think I saw the first series of, but I think it's like seven series or something. So sometimes people know that, and it has been requested in the hospital, and I can play it very simply on that one.
Now, are you learning other songs?
All the time. In fact, I usually have a little bag, and someone says, do you know, when I was playing, originally I played the prayer. I don't know if you know that song, but people have asked for that enough times that I learned that. Oops, sorry. So, and I have a lot of songs about peace and love and support for obvious reasons.
Yeah, don't we need that right
yeah.
now?
Yeah, so I play sometimes just peace songs just for my own.
Wonderful. Well, Wendy, we're down to a couple seconds here. I want you to take us out with a beautiful song, okay? Can you do that?
Sure.
It was my pleasure meeting you, and thank you so much for being on For Your Entertainment. Will you come back and see us sometime soon?
Yes, thank you so much.
Wendy Thompson, everybody, thank you so much. Thank we'll you. See you next time on For Your Entertainment. Good night, everybody. Take it away, Wendy.
For Your Entertainment is sponsored by Kevin's Lamp and Fixture Repair.